Good morning, friends. I'm out running errands today. Today's kind of a cool day. I'm doing a special event at my farmer's market pop-up. I'm doing a Day of the Dead altar. I'm gonna get my face painted, and I'm gonna set up a Day of the Dead altar at my booth so people can come and leave their offerings to their dead loved ones, honor the spirits. And I need to grab a couple things from my local neighborhood. Early worm gets the worm. Another worm? Like, are they friends? Where's that from? They got vegan pan dulce. I'm just gonna cross right here. They got the special bread that's for Dia de los Muertos, Day of the Dead. It's called pan de muerto. Basically dead bread, or bread for the dead. Actually, it would be translated as bread of death, bread of dying. Why am I laughing? I have Scorpio in the third house. I almost cleaned them out. I woke up early. I meant to wake up early and get them yesterday. You put it on your altar for your loved ones that are on the other side. A penny. No, it's not a penny. We got all kinds of altars in Highland Park, actually. Because this is kind of a transitional neighborhood. It was very rough at one point. Extremely rough. Back in the day, gentrification, things are changing. Still crazy stuff happening here all the time, man. I was afraid they'd run out of this bread. Today I have a lot to do. Even before I do my farmer's market pop-up, every Tuesday in Highland Park from 3 to 7 p.m. So busy vlogging that I forgot I need one more stop. I need to get some flowers, some marigolds. So I'm gonna put some in my hair, and I'm also gonna put some on the altar. Back to the bread. I was afraid they were gonna run out because Delicia's Bakery and some, I've talked about them before, check them out. They have vegan pan dulce. They have a lot of options because some places that have vegan pan dulce, it's only like one or two varieties. They have a lot of options. You saw in that case, I thought they were gonna run out because it's basically they make a certain amount and then that's it for the day. And they close at 3 p.m. But I was like, I need to get there early. And then I saw yesterday that they had it, and I was afraid that they wouldn't have it today, but they did have it today. So I basically cleaned them out. God, I got my hands so full right now. They smell so good. They're super fresh. I guess the lady just got cut them this morning. Oh my God, this smells so good. I'm gonna put some in my hair, like I said, with my sugar skull. I'm so excited to get done. I never got sugar skull painted on me. I actually never celebrated Day of the Dead before. I'm so excited. And I can't believe I never celebrated it before because it's so my jam. Honoring the spirits? My God, are you kidding me? I honor the spirits daily. Like a whole holiday for it is like so awesome. I'm so excited. Don't you guys love this beautiful artwork that I just got done? Oh my gosh. Thank you so much, Elizabeth. So beautiful. Okay, but I have to show you guys something. Day of the Dead honors loved ones who have passed away. Something I have not shared with you guys is that one of my macrobiotic teachers passed away earlier this year, and really sad. Today, I felt the call to make a dish that he taught me how to make, and it's called nishime vegetables. Let me show you. This is nishime vegetables. It's also called waterless cooking. Tastes amazing. When I got my consultation with him, December 7th, 2017, I had a macrobiotic consultation with my teacher, Warren Kramer, and he gave me this book full of recipes, and he wrote little notes for me specifically. When I saw Warren Kramer for this consultation, I went to see him because even though I was eating macrobiotic for a year already, I was still really struggling with depression. And a big part of that was the fact that I was still working a job I hated and I was injured. But that's when he really explained to me the importance of not just sleeping, but sleeping when you're supposed to be sleeping.
That's the main thing. My macrobiotic counselor told me that I need to get together is my sleeping pattern, and just my life pattern in general has to coincide with the natural pattern of the way that the time goes in the day, because macrobiotics, living a macrobiotic life, is not just what you eat, it's everything. It's your lifestyle, everything in your lifestyle too. He said for me, a lot of my health concerns, physical and mental, will be greatly improved, if not eliminated, if I do this one thing, is match my sleeping and my eating pattern to the cycle of the day. Your body runs on a clock, and certain things are best to do at certain times of the day. Between this hour and this hour is the best time to exercise. From this hour is the best time to have breakfast. This time is a whole thing, and it coincides with each organ. It's a very common knowledge stuff, but because the way that society has gone, all this basic principles of life, of thinking, of living your life, of eating, has just gone so, like, lost. We've lost ourselves. We've lost our power. So many things have gotten in the way. That's the whole thing.
And ever since then, I've been prioritizing my sleep schedule. And it's still not perfect and reliable, but at least I know the importance of it and the effect it has, not just on my mental health, but my total health. And I would have never known that if I didn't have Warren Kramer as my teacher. And I really appreciate everything he taught me. He helped me with my back spasms. He helped me learn how to cook. He first taught me about the five element theory. And I'm just really grateful that he shared his knowledge and his experience with me and the rest of his students. And I really, really want to continue to honor his legacy.
And Aubrey was her name. I didn't know her, but I loved her just the same. I loved her name. Wish that I had found a way, and the reasons that would make her stay, like a lovely melody that everyone can sing. Take away the words that rhyme, it doesn't mean a thing.
Alright friends, we're here today at the farmer's market, my weekly pop-up, and today is a Day of the Dead event. I have a shrine here. This is the full thing. I have a serape blanket, and I have some marigolds, which are the flowers that they usually use for Day of the Dead to honor your loved ones that passed away. I have this cup of brown rice. If you can see, it's short grain and long grain rice. And these are my teachers, Michio and Abilene Kushi. I never met them in person, but they visit me often in spirit, and I learn through their books. And I have this little cup of water for the spirits as well. And this cup was actually my grandfather's. And I have a little incense burning. I also have this little cauldron of sea salt to cleanse the space, cleanse any negative energy. And I have this pan de muerto, this vegan pan dulce. And one of them's more sugary than the other for the spirits who want to pick and choose. And so why I have brown rice? I am macrobiotic, and I know that brown rice is the best food energetically. And I'm also honoring a lot of macrobiotic people. And I have a note here to my grandparents that passed away with the rose quartz crystal. and I'm letting anyone come and put a picture or a note here. And I have this little writing station right here, and then they can choose a crystal to weigh down their note and place it somewhere here. I'll probably have to rearrange if it gets too full. And there's a lot of people I wanted to honor, and I don't have pictures of everyone. That's why I wrote the note for my grandparents, because I didn't have a physical picture. But I wanted to honor George Osawa and William Dufty, again, two macrobiotic teachers and authors. I also wanted to honor Audrey Hepburn, because her spirit is still loved today. And also because I started doing some face reading on her on TikTok, and people have the wrong idea that I'm trying to drag her. I'm not, just trying to read her face. She was very beautiful. I also want to honor Michelle Abacera, another macrobiotic teacher. Tom learned from him. I wanted to honor my teacher, Warren Kramer, and he passed away earlier this year. And I also wanted to honor Marilyn Monroe. And also, fun fact, this issue also has a story of Dr. Anthony Sadolaro. He used macrobiotics to cure himself of stage 4 cancer. There's a lot of people I wanted to honor, and I'm still gonna write some more notes and place them.
Moon's not name, love left dry, frost or flame, skeleton me, fall asleep, spin the sky. Skeleton me, love don't cry, love don't cry, love.